So hi guys, my name's Flo. I'm technical account manager here in Munich. Probably most of you guys know me already. So why am I here on stage? Because I was told I'm pretty recognizable, so now you know me. And also I'm here to talk about the images that Dominic just mentioned. So first we have to do some little groundwork. In order to make your graphics card work with the whole system, you have to create some registry entries because otherwise your graphics driver will run into a timeout. So you create those two rec keys and put in a delay of like 60, which enables the driver to wait till the frame is finished. So what you're seeing here is an exterior shot done by one of our technical artists, which Marianne. It's fully ray traced, 8K rendering. It's only using a skylight, a ray traced skylight for the lighting. We are having reflections and under clear coat bounce, so the GI and the reflection is bouncing under the clear coat. We have full ray trace translucency in that one. You can see those images because the quality is not like super great in the PowerPoint. You can see them outside, at least in 4K. Something that's really special about the shot is the geometry we used for this one is from Quixel. So as you can see, there's a lot of detail in the environment. It gives you a lot of nice lighting and a lot of good shapes. Another interesting part is that the environment is actually derived from a little site that's called HDRI Haven, and they give you 16K HDRs for free. What we did here is there's a projection mapping on the 3D geometry on the building and stuff, so this was created by us to perfectly match and get some nice shapes in there. Something that's also really important is our certain console variables we used to make this run. We turned off all the denoises, like the reflection denoiser and the GI denoiser and stuff like that. We used the second command is to enable the under cold bounces, under clear cold bounces, and just to see what's happening. So we turned off all the stuff, and this is a glimpse into the next, into future version of the Unreal Engine. So it allows you to accumulate different renders, and that's how the motion blur is actually done. So you can see here, it's built into the sequencer. Right now, you still have to start it with a console command, as it's a dev rendering, a dev branch. But as you can see, so what we're doing is you create a sequencer with some frames before the frame you want to render and some after. And then you're rendering, in this case, I think it was 256 images without denoising, without all of that stuff. And then afterwards, sequences combining the image, and you get your final image. Here you go with the motion blur. So this is directly from the Unreal Engine. The next image I'm going to talk about is this one. This is also done directly in the Unreal Engine. It's using GI, ray traced reflections, skylight, and actually there are 14 different lights in there to get the desired looks. Just a little to show what kind of key lights are in there. So there are some directional lights to get the shapes. We have a directional light here. Here's another one. And so on. We have some point lights to get the red lighting on the door. And we use some area lights, ray traced area lights, to get nice shadows and nice little details. There are actually four of those in the whole scene. Here you can see another one from the other side. We have different spotlights in there to highlight certain key elements, like on the door. And this is the most important thing, the ray traced skylight, which delivers just amazing results out of the box. We have some different console variables that are also used here. So again, like we have the denoises that can be turned off. We have something, so we turned off the texture streaming for this 8K to get really high and great textures. And the last one that's really important is the global illumination diffuse threshold, which allows you to render the GI also for like really dark parts. as I said before, this is something that will come in the future, but you can actually do this right now already with a little blueprint setup. So the first blueprint, basically what it does, it's just you're rendering the amount of times you want to render your image. Those are basically saved back to your hard drive. You re-import those. We created another blueprint. You get those images into this blueprint. What this blueprint does is basically it writes all of these images additive into one screen, into one render target. This looks like this, so it's way too bright. In the end, what you then do is you take this one and write this into another render target, which is also using a post-processing material, which basically just divides the pixel value of every pixel by the number of images that you rendered before, and in the end, you get your final image. And with that, I give the stage back to Doug.
Good job, dude.